dir ein bisschen. Ja, die zieht und schon, genau.
Ja, ja.
Considered as an uphill bicycle race. Parabas later to race was scratched. Pilot, the starter, pulled out his water clock, an operation which wet his hands unless he had merely spit on them. Pilot gave the send off. Jesus got away to a good start. In those days, according to the excellent sports commentator St. Matthew, it was customary to flagellate the sprinter at the start the way a coachman whips his horse. The whip both stimulates and gives a hygienic message. Jesus then got off in good form, but he had a flat right away. A bed of thorn punctured the whole circumstances of his front tire. Today in the shop windows of bicycle dealers, you see a reproduction of this veritable crown of thorns as an ad for puncture-proof tires. But Jesus was an ordinary single-tube racing tire. The two thieves, obviously in cahoots and therefore thicker thieves, took the lead. It is not true that there were any nails. The three objects usually shown in the ads belonged to a rapid-change tire called the Chiffy. We had better beginning by telling about the spills. But before that, the machine itself must be described. The bicycle frame in use today is a relatively recent invention. It appeared around 1890. Previous to that time, the body of the machine was constructed of two tubes soldered together at right angles. It was generally called the right angle or cross bicycle. Jesus, after his puncture, climbed the slope on foot, carrying on his shoulder the bike frame, or if you will, the cross. Contemporary engraving reproduced the scene from photography, but it appears that the sport of cycling is a result of the well-known accident which put a grievous end to the passion race and which was brought up to date almost on its anniversary by this similar accident of Count Zborowski on the turbine slope. The sport of cycling was for a time prohibited by state ordinance. Thus explains why the illustrated magazines in reproducing this celebrated scene show bicycles of a rather imaginary design. They confuse the machine's cross frame with that other cross, the straight handlebar. They represent Jesus with his hands spread on the handlebars. And it is worth mentioning in this connection that Jesus rode lying flat on his back in order to reduce his air resistance. Note also that the frame across was made of wood, just as wheels are to this day. A few people insinuated falsely that Jesus' machine was a drazier, an unlikely mount for a hill climbing contest. According to the old cyclophile hagiographers Saint Bridget, Saint Gregory of Tours and Saint Irene, the cross was equipped with a device which they named supendaneum. There is no need to be a great scholar to translate this as paddle. Lipsius, Lustianius, Bosius, and Iricus Putenius describe another accessory which one still finds, according to the Cornelius Curtius in 1643, on Japanese crosses, a protuberance of leather or wood on the shaft which the rider sits astride, manifestly the seat or saddle. Ooh. This general description furthermore suits the definition of a bicycle current among the Chinese, a little mule which is led by the ears and urged along by showering it with kicks. We shall abridge the story of the race itself, for it has been narrated in detail by specialized works and illustrated by sculpture and painting visible in monuments built to house such art. There are 14 turns in the difficult gold gate course. Jesus took his first spill at the third turn. His mother, who was in the stands, became alarmed. His excellent trainer, Simon the Cyrenian, who put for the thorn accident, would have been waiting out in front to cut the wind, carried the machine. Jesus, through carrying nothing, perspired heavily. It is not certain whether a female spectator whipped his brow, but we know that Veronica, a girl reporter, got a good shot of him with her Kodak. The second spill came at the seventh turn on some slippery pavement. Jesus went down for the third time at the 11th turn, skidding on a rail. The Israelite Deminondans waved the handkerchief at the 8th. The deplorable accident familiar to us all took place at the 12th turn. Jesus was in a dead heat at the time with the thieves. We know that he continued the race airborne. But that is another story.